बताना चाहता हूँ कि डॉक्टर गिरीश ओक जो हमारे एनआईएमए के ब्रांड एम्बेसडर है तथा अपने वो खुद बीएमएस डॉक्टर है और निमा का प्राथमिक सदस्यत्व तो उन्होंने लिया है और वो बहुत दिनों से बहुत सालों से निमा से जुड़े हुए हैं और वो हमेशा हमारे कार्यक्रम में या हमारे कोई भी रिक्वेस्ट को विनंती को मान देते हुए हमेशा हमें सहकार्य करते हैं। लेकिन पिछली बार थोड़ा टेक्निकल प्रॉब्लम आने की वजह से वो ज्वाइन नहीं हो सके और इस बार उद्घाटक उनको ही लेना था। हमने उनसे रिक्वेस्ट की थी, उन्होंने मान्य भी कर दी थी, लेकिन कल ही उनका फोन आया कि वो थोड़ा सा रिमोट में जाएंगे। अगर मैं वहाँ पे नेटवर्क रहेंगे, उनका शूटिंग है, अगर नेटवर्क रहेगा तो ज्वाइन रहूँगा, नहीं तो थोड़ा सा प्रॉब्लम है। तो आज अब तक हमने राह देखी लेकिन सर ज्वाइन नहीं हो सक रहे हैं। तो मैं आज के इस कार्यक्रम के उद्घाटक हमारे मार्गदर्शक डॉक्टर आशुतोष जी कुलकर्णी सर को विनंती करता हूँ कि वो आज के इस कार्यक्रम का उद्घाटक पद स्वीकार करें। डॉक्टर आशुतोष जी कुलकर्णी, कोषाध्यक्ष, महाराष्ट्र राज्य, सॉरी एनआईएमए केंद्रीय शाखा। कार्यक्रम को आगे ले जाते हुए मैं महाराष्ट्र के अध्यक्ष डॉक्टर सुहास जाधव जी सर से अनुरोध करूंगा कि वो प्रास्ताविक करें। लेकिन कार्यक्रम की शुरुआत हम हमेशा धन्वंतरी स्तवन से करते हैं, तो आज के इस कार्यक्रम को धन्वंतरी स्तवन से शुरुआत करेंगे और धन्वंतरी स्तवन के लिए मैं बुलाता हूँ डॉक्टर स्वाति बोमनोटे मैडम जो कि अमरावती से है और उनका मैं स्वागत करता हूँ। डॉक्टर स्वाति बोमनोटे मैडम,
शङ्खं चक्रं जलोकान् दधतं मृतघटं चारुदोर्भिश्चतुर्भिः सूक्ष्मस्वच्छातिरुद्यां शुकपरिविलसन् मौलिमम्भोजनेत्रम् कालाम्भोदोज्ज्वलाङ्गं कटितटविलसश्चारुपीताम्बराढ्यम् वन्दे धन्वन्तरिं तं निखिलगदवनं प्रौढदावाग्निनीलं प्रौढदावाग्निनीलम् ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः।
ओम श्री धन्वंतरी नमः। डॉक्टर स्वाति बोमनोटे मैडम, आपका मैं आभार मानता हूँ और कार्यक्रम को आगे ले जाते हुए अध्यक्ष डॉक्टर सुहास जाधव जी सर से अनुरोध करता हूँ कि अपना प्रास्ताविक सादर करें।
धन्यवाद अनिल जी बादरे सर। नमस्कार, गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीबॉडी। निमा सेंट्रल काउंसिल के अध्यक्ष और आज के ये वेबिनार के शुभारंभ कार्यक्रम के अध्यक्ष डॉक्टर विनायक जी टेम्बुर्णीकर सर, हमारे सबके मार्गदर्शक व निमा सेंट्रल काउंसिल के कोषाध्यक्ष और आज का ये वेबिनार ओपनिंग करने वाले डॉक्टर आशुतोष जी कुलकर्णी सर, निमा सेंट्रल विमेन्स फोरम के अध्यक्ष डॉक्टर साधना कुलकर्णी मैडम, आज के वेबिनार के उद्घाटक जो लोकप्रिय अभिनेता है वो आज अगर नहीं भी होंगे तो मुझे लगता है अगर उनको एक्सेस मिला तो वो ज्वाइन हो सकते हैं, इसलिए उनका नाम लिए बगैर मैं आगे नहीं जा सकता हूँ। तो आज के कार्यक्रम में उद्घाटक जो थे लोकप्रिय सिने टीवी मालिका नाट्य अभिनेते लेखक और अपने डॉक्टर गिरिजी अक्सर, नीमा महाराष्ट्र राज्य के सेक्रेटरी डॉक्टर अनिल जी बादारे सर, कोषाध्यक्ष डॉक्टर भूषण जी वाणी सर, आज के सेमिनार में पेन मैनेजमेंट आयुर्वेदा वे इस विषय पर हम सबको मार्गदर्शन करने वाले प्रोफेसर और चिकित्सा विभाग प्रमुख सायन महाविद्यालय डॉक्टर अनया पाथरीकर मैडम आज के लेक्चर के चेयरपर्सन और विद्ध व अग्निकर्म चिकित्सा स्पेशलिस्ट डॉक्टर चंद्र कुमार देशमुख सर, आज के हमारे प्रायोजक हेम स्ट्रीट प्राइवेट लिमिटेड के एमडी श्रेय जैन सर और वाइस प्रेसिडेंट डॉक्टर पूजा कोहली मैडम, नीमा महाराष्ट्र राज्य कार्यकारिणी के सभी सभासद, ऑफिस बियरर्स उपस्थित, नीमा स्थानिक शाखा के अध्यक्ष, सचिव, कोषाध्यक्ष व उपस्थित सभी ज्ञान प्रेमी आईएसएम ग्रेजुएट डॉक्टर्स व नीमा सदस्य। नीमा महाराष्ट्र राज्य के सबके प्रयत्न के अनुसार आज ये ज्ञान यज्ञ ऑनलाइन वेबिनार सीरीज अपने आईएसएम ग्रेजुएट्स और नीमा सदस्यों के नॉलेज अपडेट करने के लिए हम शुरू कर रहे हैं, और ये उद्घाटन सोहरा आज जो हो रहा है उसके लिए मुझे बहुत आनंद है। डियर फ्रेंड्स, टुडे इज द डे वी वर वेटिंग फॉर अ लॉन्ग टाइम। मी एंड माई कलीग्स wanted very sincerely to share knowledge updates required in day-to-day practice for the practitioners, government and private medical officers, and also UG and PG students in all over Maharashtra state. It is a basic need of any ISM graduate, and we are marching towards the same from today onwards. We will have eminent speakers from all over the state to share with you the updates in various subjects, from pediatric to gynecology, from medicine to orthopedic, from dermatology to surgery, from gastroenterology to oncology, from geriatric to cardiology, likewise in allopathy as well as in Ayurvedic also. We will try to cover as many as topics as we can in this 1 year period program. Every second and fourth Saturday of every month between 3 p.m. to 4:30 p.m. this Dhyan Yajna will be operational for all NEMA and non-NEMA ISM graduates and PG fraternity. Please take advantage of the same and spread among all your friends, colleagues to do so. In this endeavor, Dr. Vishnu Bhavane sir and Dr. Padmanabh Keskar sir, both our coordinators for this webinar series, are doing a great job for us. Also, a team of enthusiastic doctors from NEMA family will be helping them to carry on this Jnan Yajna series. Dr. Manish Joshi sir and Dr. Girish Daga sir are also taking the responsibility of technical help throughout the webinar series, and I thank them for the support and dedication. Soon, a team of young aspirant NEMA doctors will also take their responsibility as this series goes on. I thank Honorable President NEMA Central Council, Dr. Vinayakji Tembulnikar sir, and our mentor and guide, Dr. Ashutoshji Kulkarni sir, treasurer NEMA Central Council, for their kind support and guidance for this Jnan Yajna webinar series project to move forwards for the benefit of our NEMA members and all ISM graduates in the states. My sincere thanks to Honorable Dr. Giriji Oak sir, a well-known popular film, theater and serial actor, writer and a brand ambassador of NEMA for the last few years, who immediately responded to our request to open the Jnan Yajna series today, taking pain from his busy schedule. He is truly a well-wisher of NEMA and all ISM graduates, being an ISM graduate himself. I remember Dr. Girijji, he was the chief guest to our NEMA Pimpri-Chinchwad branch Silver Jubilee year function in 2001, where he inaugurated our souvenir Haropyamai. I was the secretary of Nima Pimpernel branch then. His gentle and down-to-earth personality speaks the story. And that's why he is a popular figure in all these fields like films, drama, series, and theater. We are thankful for your presence in this on this platform and are proud to share this stage with you, Girishok sir. I read biodata of Dr. Anaya Patrikar madam, today's speaker, and was highly impressed. She was topper in all university UG and PG exams and done PhD with best thesis award. Her another PG in clinical research and pharmacovigilance is due to her interest in the research sector. She is author of two books also. Now she is professor and head of the department of Chikitsa in Sion College, Mumbai. She is a university examiner, PG, PhD guide, co-chairman of various committees, co-investigator and research associate for various clinical trials. And there is many more. I welcome you, Dr. Anaya Patrikar madam, on this platform of Dhyan Yadna web series, and wish and I hope that your association with Nima will be for a longer period. I thank Dr. Chandra Kumar Deshmukh sir. He is a Vidha and Agnikarma specialist who has done it under the kind guidance of our beloved head of the department of Tilak Ayurved Mahavidyalaya and Seth Tarajna Ramnath Hospital, R.B. Gokte sir. In all, I appeal to all NIMA members and ISM graduates who in various fields to take advantage of this wonderful knowledge updation series on every second and fourth Saturday. Please register and let your friends, colleagues to do so. Everybody will get e-certificate also. महाराष्ट्र राज्य के सभी नीमा मेंबर्स और सभी नॉन नीमा आईसीएम ग्रेजुएट्स के लिए ये ज्ञान यज्ञ अद्यावत रहने के लिए हमने शुरू किया है और इस दैनंदिन जीवन में अपने डे टू डे प्रैक्टिस में अगर आप प्रैक्टिशनर हैं या आप सरकारी सेवा में गवर्नमेंट ऑफिसर्स हैं मेडिकल ऑफिसर्स हैं खासगी हॉस्पिटल में या क्लिनिक में हाउसमैन है मेडिकल ऑफिसर है या अपन यूजी या पीजी स्टूडेंट है आप सबको नॉलेज अपडेट करने की जरूरत है विशेष करके जो नए नए रुग्ण हम देखते हैं उसी वक्त हर रोज हमें निदान और उपचार का ट्रेंड या पैटर्न बदलता दिखता है अभी COVID-19 का ही हम उदाहरण ले ले गेले 1.5-2 साल के अंदर कोविड रुग्ण उपचार का तफसील हम देखेंगे तो उसमें बहुत बदलाव होता हुआ दिखाई दे रहा है इसलिए इस बारे में जो जो डिसीजंस है उसके डायग्नोसिस में उसके ट्रीटमेंट में या डायग्नोस्टिक मॉड्यूल्स में बहुत जो बदलाव हो रहा है उसके लिए हमें अपडेट रहना जरूरी है ये हमारे लिए और समाज के लिए भी हितकारक है इसलिए नीमा ने अपडेट करने का काम पिछले 73 ईयर से कंटिन्यूसली कर रहे हैं और इसके आगे भी नीमा ये काम करती रहेगी इस वेबिनार सीरीज के उपलक्ष्य में आप सब ISM ग्रेजुएट्स हमारे मित्र परिवार और नीमा सभासद से कम्युनिकेट करता करने को हमें जो अवसर मिला है उसके लिए और आपके साथ संवाद करने का जो अवसर मिला है उसके लिए हमें बहुत खुशी है और मैं समझता हूँ ये बहुत महत्वपूर्ण भी है हमारा ये संवाद सुसंवाद ही रहेगा इसका मुझे अनुमान है और गेली 73 ईयर्स नीमा यानी नेशनल इंटीग्रेटेड मेडिकल एसोसिएशन आपके समस्याओं के लिए आपके तकलीफों के लिए आपके व्यवसाय में जो बाधा होने वाले नियम और सरकारी आदेश आपके हित में और आपके मेडिकल प्रैक्टिस सुसह्य हो इसीलिए नीमा संघर्ष करते आई है और इसके आगे भी करती रहेंगी मित्रों नीमा महाराष्ट्र राज्य में 260 से भी ज्यादा जो शाखाएं हैं और सब लेकर आपके लिए, आप सब ISM ग्रेजुएट्स के हित रक्षण के लिए और आपके न्याय हकों के लिए हम काम करते रहेंगे और नीमा काम करती रहेंगी, इसकी मैं आपको गवाही देना चाहता हूँ। जय हिंद, जय महाराष्ट्र, जय नीमा।
थैंक यू सर, आपने जो मार्गदर्शन किया है, जो जो प्रास्ताविक किया है, उससे इस वेबिनार सीरीज की संपूर्ण जानकारी सबको आई होगी ऐसी आशा करता हूँ। इसके बाद मैं आमंत्रित करता हूँ हमारे मार्गदर्शक राष्ट्रीय कोषाध्यक्ष डॉक्टर आशीष कुलकर्णी सर, और वो आज के कार्यक्रम का उद्घाटन भी जाहिर करें और हमें मार्गदर्शन करें, ऐसी मैं उनको विनंती करता हूँ। डॉक्टर आशुतोष कुलकर्णी सर।
हेलो,
हाँ बोला सर, बोला सर, प्लीज।
हाँ 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 दूसरा मैडम से मोबाइल वरना बोलते हैं।
हाँ
हाँ बोला सर, हाँ 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 नमस्कार सगळ्या पार्टिसिपंट्स, मनापासून स्वागत। महाराष्ट्राचा प्रोग्राम आहे, महाराष्ट्र शाखेने अरेंज केलेला, त्याच्यामुळे मराठी प्रिफर करायलाच पाहिजे, त्याच्यामुळे मी मराठीतूनच बोलतोय। अच्छा, या कार्यक्रमाच्या निमित्ताने आज जो एक प्रकारचं यज्ञाचं जे आयोजन महाराष्ट्र शाखेने केलंय, त्याबद्दल सगळ्यात प्रथम महाराष्ट्र शाखेचं मनापासून अभिनंदन, आणि त्याचबरोबर आपण सर्वजण इतक्या प्रचंड संख्येने जे सहभागी झालेले आहात, त्या आपल्या सगळ्यांचं पण मनापासून अभिनंदन। जर आपण संघटनेचा इतिहास बघितला, संघटनेचा इतिहास बघताना जर आपण थोडस सिंहावलोकन जर केलं, तर आपल्याला ह्या गोष्टी निश्चितच जाणवतात की संघटना म्हणल्यानंतर संघटना ही काही कुणा एका व्यक्तीशी बांधील नाहीये, तर संपूर्ण भारतामध्ये जे काही आपले ISM प्रॅक्टिशनर आहेत, त्या ISM प्रॅक्टिशनरचं हित कशामध्ये आहे, त्या हितासाठी वेळप्रसंगी आंदोलन करणं, मोर्चे काढणं, कोर्टामध्ये जाणं आणि त्यांना न्याय मिळवून देणं, मग तो आमचा ग्रॅज्युएट जनरल प्रॅक्टिशनर असू द्या, कन्सल्टंट असू द्या, टीचर्स असू द्या, मेडिकल ऑफिसर असू द्या, कुठल्याही कॅटेगरीचा जरी असेल तरी त्याच्या हक्कासाठी बांधणं आणि त्याचबरोबर इंटिग्रेशनचा पुरस्कार करणं, यासाठी संघटना अविरत गेल्या 74-75 वर्षापासून काम करते आहे आणि भविष्यातही ती इंटिग्रेशनच्या पुरस्कारासाठी झगडत राहणार आहे, भांडत राहणार आहे। याचा अर्थ हा नाहीये की आम्ही संघटना आयुर्वेदाकडे दुर्लक्ष करते किंवा आयुर्वेदाला कमी लेखल्या जात असं नाहीये, तर जे एक सध्या आपण पाहतोय किंवा अगदी जुन्या काळापासून सुद्धा, म्हणजे महात्मा गांधी असताना सुद्धा त्यांनी सुद्धा ह्या इंटिग्रेशनचा जो एक पुरस्कार केला होता की समन्वय, पॅथीचा समन्वय करून चिकित्सा विकसित करायला पाहिजे की जेणेकरून त्या ठिकाणी पेशंटचं हित कशामध्ये आहे, आणि जास्तीत जास्त आपण जे सगळे डॉक्टर्स आहेत आपण हे पेशंटसाठी असतो आणि पेशंटला लवकरात लवकर आराम कसा देता येईल यासाठी जर आपण दोन चिकित्सा पद्धतीचं मिश्रण करून जर आपण रुग्णाला बरं करत असू तर ती अतिशय चांगली गोष्ट आहे। आणि हे सुद्धा आम्ही न शिकता आम्हाला प्रॅक्टिस करू द्या अशातला भाग नाही, अशी आमची मागणी पण नाहीये, तर आम्ही हे टोटल शिकलोय आणि त्याचं ज्ञान आम्हाला आहे आणि त्यामुळेच आम्ही या हक्कासाठी भांडतोय। आणि आज आपण जर पाहिलं असेल तर ह्या सगळ्याचा परिपाक म्हणून की आता नवीन नॅशनल कमिशन फॉर इंडियन मेडिसिन जे फॉर्म झालंय आणि त्यांच्या थ्रू सुद्धा ज्या काही हालचाली सुरू आहेत त्यामध्ये सुद्धा सेंट्रल गव्हर्नमेंट सुद्धा इंटिग्रेशनचा पुरस्कार करत आहे, त्याचीच आपल्याला एक झलक मध्यंतरी दिसली की जे आमचे शल्यमध्ये पोस्ट ग्रॅज्युएट्स आहेत, शालाक्यामध्ये पोस्ट ग्रॅज्युएट्स आहेत, त्या लोकांना काही प्रमाणामध्ये सर्जरी करण्यासंदर्भात जो एक जी आर काढला, जे गॅझेट पब्लिश केलं, नॉट जी आर बट गॅझेट पब्लिश केलंय, त्या गॅझेटवरनं हे लक्षात येते की सेंट्रल गव्हर्नमेंटला सुद्धा हे पटलेलं आहे आणि हे पटलंय म्हणजे आम्ही त्यांना पटवून देण्यात यशस्वी झालोय हे आपल्याला अभिमानाने सांगावं लागेल। कारण हा लढा जेव्हा सुरू झाला एनसीआयएसएमच्या संदर्भामध्ये तर नीती आयोगापासून आपण सगळे त्या ठिकाणी एफर्ट्स घेतलेले आहेत, नीती आयोगाचे सगळे सदस्य त्याचे उपाध्यक्ष यांना भेटून, अनेक खासदार मिनिस्टर सगळ्यांना भेटून आपण हा लढा उभारला होता आणि या लढ्याला आपल्याला जे यश येतंय त्याची जी फळं आपल्याला दिसतात आहेत ती हळूहळू अजून आपल्याला दिसणार आहेत। आणि ह्या सगळ्या याच्यामध्ये संघटनेतर्फे मग ती महाराष्ट्र शाखा असो किंवा कर्नाटक असो, उत्तर प्रदेश, दिल्ली, कुठली शाखा असो द्या, त्या सगळ्या शाखांमधनं आपल्या जे आपले मेंबर्स आहेत, जे आपले ग्रॅज्युएट्स आहेत, त्यांच्या नॉलेजमध्ये भर पडावी, जे त्यांचं नॉलेज जे आहे चिकित्सेच्या दृष्टिकोनातनं अपडेट व्हावं आणि त्याचा उपयोग त्याला त्याच्या प्रॅक्टिसमध्ये करता यावा म्हणून सतत कार्यरत असतात। ह्या सीएमई आपण सतत घेत असतो आणि उद्देश हाच असतो की जे एखादा डॉक्टर किंवा एखादा पदवीधर जो शिकल्यानंतर इतक्या वर्षाची त्याच्यामध्ये जे गॅप पडते ते त्याचं जे नॉलेज आहे, त्याचं जे ज्ञान आहे, हे निरंतर अपडेट होणं किंवा राहणं हे आवश्यक आहे। त्या दृष्टिकोनातनं आपण हे प्रयत्न करतोय आणि त्याला सगळीकडनं आपल्याला चांगला प्रतिसाद मिळतोय। हे आपण आता मध्यंतरी जे सेंट्रल विमेन्स फोरम तर्फे किंवा स्टेट विमेन्स फोरम तर्फे जे काही वेबिनार झाले त्याला सुद्धा जो काही प्रचंड प्रतिसाद मिळाला त्यावरून आपल्याला हे लक्षात येतं की हे काळाची गरज आहे आणि ती गरज आपण आपल्या पद्धतीने आपण भागवतोय। त्याचबरोबर संघटनेमध्ये आपण आता जे काही सध्याच्या याच्यानुसार जे आपण बदल केलेले आहेत किंवा करतो आहोत की त्यामध्ये आपल्या सगळ्या स्पेशालिटी आपण त्याचं वेगवेगळं फोरम करतोय। आता ऑब्स्टेट्रिक अँड गायनेक याचं ओबीजीवाय निमा ओबीजीवाय फोरम याचं इनॉग्रेशन किंवा याची जी पहिली नॅशनल लेवलची कार्यकारिणी आहे साधारण आपण डिसेंबर फर्स्ट वीक मध्ये जाहीर करतोय। त्याचबरोबर पाईपलाईन मध्ये आता लवकरात लवकर एक आपली डर्मॅटॉलॉजी सोसायटी निमाची होते आहे, प्रोक्टोलॉजी सोसायटी ऑलरेडी कार्यरत आहे आणि अतिशय चांगल्या प्रकारे कार्य करते आहे, पीडियाट्रिक सोसायटी पण आपली जी निमाची आहे ती सुद्धा अतिशय चांगल्या प्रकारे काम करते आहे, भविष्यामध्ये सर्जिकल सोसायटी आहे, मेडिसिनची आहे, चालाक्याची आहे, ह्या सगळ्या आपण क्रमाक्रमाने आपण करतोय आणि त्या त्या वर्गामध्ये त्यांना स्पेशालिटींना सामावून घेऊन त्यांचे प्रश्न सोडवणं किंवा त्यांच्या एकत्रीकरणासाठी हा सगळं आपण प्रयत्न करतोय आणि त्याला आपल्याला अखिल भारतीय स्तरावरनं सगळीकडनं आपल्याला चांगला प्रतिसाद मिळतोय। संघटना आपल्यासाठी हे करत आहे म्हटल्यानंतर आपल्या सदस्यांचं किंवा प्रॅक्टिशनरचं किंवा जे ग्रॅज्युएट्स आहेत त्यांचं सुद्धा काहीतरी कर्तव्य या ठिकाणी असतं आणि ते कर्तव्य म्हणजे कमीत कमी त्यांनी संघटनेचं सदस्यत्व स्वीकारावं आणि संघटनेला बळकटी द्यावी एवढी अपेक्षा संघटनेला तुमच्याकडनं आहे। आणि हा जो एक ज्ञानयज्ञ जो आपण सुरू केला आहे तर ह्या यज्ञामध्ये आपल्याला यज्ञ म्हणल्यानंतर त्याच्यामध्ये आहुती ही टाकावीच लागते, आहुती टाकल्याशिवाय यज्ञ हा प्रज्वलित राहत नाही, त्याच्या ज्वाळा जे आहेत त्या विझत नाही आणि हे आहुती टाकण्यासाठी आपल्याकडे आज वेगवेगळे प्लॅटफॉर्म्स आहेत। एक त्याच्यामध्ये आपल्याला जर आपण विचार केला तर आयोजक समिती आहे महाराष्ट्र स्टेट ज्यांनी आयोजन केलं ते याच्यामध्ये आहुती टाकतात, आमची टेक्निकल टीम आहे ती याच्यामध्ये आहुती टाकते आहे, जे आमचे वर्षभर स्पीकर राहणार आहेत तर ते त्यांच्या ज्ञानाची सुद्धा याच्यामध्ये आहुती टाकणार आहेत। आणि दुसरं म्हणजे जास्तीत जास्त संख्येने उपस्थित राहून प्रतिसाद देऊन सगळ्या सदस्यांनी सुद्धा एक प्रकारची उपस्थित राहण्याची आहुती याच्यामध्ये टाकावी की जेणेकरून हा आमचा जो ज्ञानयज्ञाचा जो संकल्प आहे, जो आमचा हा प्रकल्प आहे, तो वर्षभर असाच धगधगत राहील आणि त्याचा ज्ञान त्याचा लाभ आम्हा सगळ्यांना घेता येईल. तर एवढीच या प्रसंगी मी एक छोटीशी अपेक्षा आपल्या सगळ्याकडनं व्यक्त करतो. आणि आजच्या ह्या वेबिनार सिरीजचं उद्घाटन झालं हे मी जाहीर करतो. आयोजकांनी ह्या प्रसंगी जे 2 शब्द बोलण्याची संधी दिली त्याबद्दल मनापासून महाराष्ट्र राज्य शाखा आणि उपस्थित सर्व मान्यवर आमचे निमाचे केंद्रीय अध्यक्ष सगळ्यांचे मी मनापासून धन्यवाद देतो. जय हिंद जय निमा.
थँक्यू थँक्यू सर.
थँक्यू थँक्यू व्हेरी मच सर. आपण आप हमेशा हमें मार्गदर्शन करते हैं, मार्गदर्शन करते रहेंगे. और डॉक्टर गिरीश जी ओक न आने की वजह से जो उद्घाटक का जो दायित्व है जो आपने निभाया उसके लिए भी मैं आपका शुक्रगुजार हूँ. आपका एनआईएमए महाराष्ट्र राज्य शाखा और मैं वैयक्तिक शतश आभारी हूँ. इसके बाद मैं इस कार्यक्रम का उद्घाटन हो गया और इसके जो एक कार्यक्रम के अध्यक्ष जो है जो हमारे एनआईएमए केंद्रीय शाखा के अध्यक्ष विनायक जी टेंबुलनिकर सर जो सोलापुर से है लेकिन उनको उनका परिचय देने की जरूरत नहीं है. वो सबको चिर परिचित है तो मैं उनसे अनुरोध करता हूँ कि वो अपना अध्यक्षीय भाषण दे हमें मार्गदर्शन करे. डॉक्टर विनायक जी टेंबुलनिकर सर.
थैंक यू अनिल जी. कार्यक्रम महाराष्ट्र का है, मैं भी महाराष्ट्र का हूँ लेकिन ऑल इंडिया प्रेसिडेंट का दायित्व है और इस प्रोग्राम में बहुत से नॉन महाराष्ट्रियन लोग भी है तो आई विल टॉक इन हिंदी और इंग्लिश एज मेनी हैव रिक्वेस्टेड इन द चैट बॉक्स. रिस्पेक्टेड गेस्ट, टुडेज गेस्ट डॉक्टर आशुतोष जी, प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ निमा महाराष्ट्र स्टेट ब्रांच डॉक्टर सुहास, सेक्रेटरी डॉक्टर अनिल, ट्रेजरर डॉक्टर भूषण, टेक्निकल जो टीम है उसमें डॉक्टर गिरीश एंड डॉक्टर मनीष, जो वेबिनार का आज का वेबिनार की यशस्विता के लिए जो टीम दिन रात काम कर रही है वो पूरी टीम, निमा वुमेन्स फोरम ऑल इंडिया के प्रेसिडेंट साधना जी और बाकी आज के स्पीकर और जो भी पदाधिकारी उपस्थित वो सभी और बड़ी संख्या में उपस्थित जूम प्लेटफॉर्म पे और यूट्यूब पे हमारे आईएसएम डॉक्टर्स सभी को अभिवादन. मैं खास करके महाराष्ट्र स्टेट ब्रांच का बहुत बड़ा आभारी हूँ और अभिनंदन भी करना चाहता हूँ कि ज्ञान यज्ञ उन्होंने शुरू किया है. जैसे कि आशुतोष जी ने कहा है यज्ञ में संविधा सबको देना पड़ता है और हम सब लोग इसमें संविधा दे रहे हैं, आप सब लोग दे रहे हैं, हम भी दे रहे हैं. जैसे कि सर ने कहा कि अटेंड कर रहे हैं वो सभी, उनका अटेंडेंस भी एक संविधा ही है. तो एक ज्ञान यज्ञ की जो शुरुआत महाराष्ट्र स्टेट ब्रांच ने की है, हमारे जो नवनिर्वाचित प्रेसिडेंट है डॉक्टर सुभाष जी जाधव, इनकी कल्पना से ये प्रोग्राम ने जन्म लिया है और उन्होंने उनके दिमाग में एक चल रहा था कि निमा आंदोलन तो करती है, हम कोर्ट केसेस लड़ते हैं, रास्ते पे उतर के हम लोग आंदोलन करते हैं, अपने लोगों के हक के लिए लड़ते हैं, उनकी जो भी मांगे हैं डिमांड है उनको पूरा करने के लिए जी जान से हम पूरे 70-72 साल से लगे हुए हैं. ये करते वक्त हमारी ज्ञान लालसा जो है, जो थर्स्ट ऑफ नॉलेज है, उसके लिए भी हम लोग काम करते हैं और इसी के अंदर डॉक्टर सुहास जाधव जी ने एक प्रोग्राम दिया था ज्ञान यज्ञ और ये यज्ञ पूरी साल भर चलता रहेगा. पूरे साल भर हर महीने में 2 लेक्चर्स ऐसा एक प्रोग्राम उन्होंने बनाया है और मैंने वो सूची देखी है, बहुत ही एमिनेंट स्पीकर्स उन्होंने आयुर्वेदा और एलोपैथी के रखे हैं. ऐसा कहा जाता था कि निमा सिर्फ एलोपैथी की तरफ ध्यान देती है, एलोपैथी का अधिकार मिले इसके लिए काम करती है और आयुर्वेद की तरफ ध्यान नहीं देती. ये सब झुटलाते हुए ज्यादा से ज्यादा लेक्चर हमने आयुर्वेद के रखे हैं इसमें और ज्ञान लालसा में हम लोगों का हर ब्रांच जो है वो काम कर रही है. जैसे कि अभी आशुतोष जी ने अपनी इसमें कहा कि महाराष्ट्र वुमेन्स फोरम ने गर्भ संवाद के ऊपर एक वेब लेक्चर सीरीज ली. अभी वुमेन्स फोरम ऑल इंडिया जो सेंट्रल ब्रांच है उनकी तरफ से गायनेकोलॉजी के ऊपर एक बड़ा वेबिनार हो रहा है जिसमें डॉक्टर जय मेहता अपना नॉलेज सब लोगों के साथ बांट रहे। हर एक ब्रांच, हर एक स्टेट ब्रांच, लोकल ब्रांच, इसी तरह के सीएमईज, वेब सीएमईज लेके हमारी जो ज्ञान लालसा है उसका पूर्ति के लिए काम कर रही है। तो हम लोग सिर्फ आंदोलन करना है, अपने हकों के लिए लड़ना या हमारे लोगों की भलाई के लिए काम करना, यही करते नहीं है। तो हम लोग अपना अपग्रेडेशन ऑफ द नॉलेज, वी आर वर्किंग ऑन दैट फ्रंट ऑल्सो। इसके साथ ही साथ हम लोग बहुत से सेक्टर में काम कर रहे हैं। हम लोगों के मनोरंजन के क्षेत्र में हम लोग काम करते हैं, बहुत से ब्रांचेस हमारे मनोरंजन के अनेक कार्यक्रम रखते हैं, अनेक प्रोग्राम्स लिए जाते हैं। स्पोर्ट्स के इसमें अभी मेरी जो होम ब्रांच है सोलापुर ब्रांच, उसके वुमेन्स फोरम में हाल ही में एक क्रिकेट टूर्नामेंट लिया था स्टेट लेवल का, लेडीज का, ओनली फॉर फीमेल डॉक्टर्स, वुमेन्स फोरम का हो गया था। ऐसे हम हर सेक्टर में हम लोग काम कर रहे हैं। दूसरा, जैसे आशुतोष जी ने कहा है कि हम लोग जनरल प्रैक्टिस के लिए काम करते हैं, हम लोग टीचर्स के लिए काम कर रहे हैं, हम लोग वुमेन्स फोरम के माध्यम से हमारी जो लेडीज पावर है उसके लिए काम कर रहे हैं, हम स्टूडेंट फोरम के माध्यम से काम कर रहे हैं। हमने पूरे इसमें स्पेशलिटी फोरम बनाए हैं जिसमें सर्जिकल सोसाइटी हो, पेडियाट्रिक सोसाइटी हो, एनोरेक्टल सोसाइटी हो, रिप्रोडक्टिव स्पेशलिटी जो है वो है, और हर सेक्टर में हम लोग काम करते हैं। हर स्पेशलिटी की हमने ब्रांच बनाई है, हर इसके लिए हम लोग काम कर रहे हैं। अपनी जो लीगल राइट्स है उसके लिए तो हम लोग सुप्रीम कोर्ट से लेकर लोकल कोर्ट तक लड़ते ही हैं, और इसके लिए हम लोगों को चाहिए आप सब लोगों का साथ। दोस्तों, आज मैं देख रहा था लिस्ट, इसमें बहुत से लोग नीमा से जो ज्ञान यज्ञ इसमें जुड़े हैं, लेकिन नीमा की मेंबरशिप बहुत से लोगों के साथ नहीं है, उन्होंने मेंबरशिप नहीं ली। विद दिस आई टेक द अपॉर्चुनिटी टू रिक्वेस्ट ऑल ऑफ यू टू ज्वाइन नीमा। जिन्होंने भी नीमा ज्वाइन नहीं किए, दे आर वेलकम इन द नीमा फैमिली। नीमा हर सेक्टर से, हर एंगल से काम करते हैं। और दूसरी बात, पते की बात ऐसी है, जब तक हम लोग यूनाइटेड नहीं रहेंगे, जब तक हम लोग इकट्ठा नहीं रहेंगे, तब तक हम लोग आईएमए जैसे हमारा जो साथी संगठन है एलोपैथी डॉक्टर्स का, जो हमारे हर विकास में, हमारे हर राइट में, हमारी हर तरक्की में जो रोड़ा डालने का काम करते हैं, उसके साथ हम लोग नहीं लड़ सकते हैं, क्योंकि उनका एक ही संगठन है, वो बहुत स्ट्रांग है। और हमारे यहाँ नीमा अभी सबसे स्ट्रांग है, लेकिन बहुत से लोग जो जुड़े नहीं है उनसे मैं आई टेक दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी टू रिक्वेस्ट यू ऑल दोज हु आर नॉट मेंबर्स ऑफ नीमा टू ज्वाइन नीमा एंड ज्वाइन हैंड्स ऑफ नीमा एंड मेक यूर सेल्फ स्ट्रांग, मेक नीमा स्ट्रांग। विद दिस आई कंक्लूड माई वर्ड्स, एज मेनी ऑफ हैव कवर्ड ऑल द टॉपिक्स एंड यू आर ईगर टू हियर द लेक्चर ऑफ अवर एमिनेंट स्पीकर ऑफ टूडे and the pain management, the Ayurveda way. So with this, I conclude my speech. Thank you. Jai Hind, Jai Nima.
Thank you, sir. आपका बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद। आपने हमें वेबिनार सीरीज का जो उद्घाटन कार्यक्रम है उसका अध्यक्ष पद स्वीकार करके उपकृत किया, उसके लिए मैं आपका आभारी हूँ। आपका मार्गदर्शन हमें हमेशा प्रेरणादायी रहता है। अभी कार्यक्रम के आखिरी चरण की तरफ लेते जाते हुए मैं डॉक्टर भूषण वानी सर, कोषाध्यक्ष एनआईएमए महाराष्ट्र राज्य शाखा, इनको विनंती करता हूं कि कृपया वो अपना आभार प्रदर्शन प्रकट करें।
आभार प्रदर्शन,
यस, आभार प्रदर्शन, यस, आभार प्रदर्शन। ये उद्घाटन कार्यक्रम का है, इसके बाद उद्घाटन कार्यक्रम समाप्त हो जाएगा और आगे का कार्यक्रम जो लेक्चर सीरीज का है, जो इसके बाद में टाइम टू टाइम होते रहेगा, तो उसकी शुरुआत होगी।
धन्यवाद बाजारे सर। इस आज के इस ज्ञान यज्ञ का आज शुभारंभ हो गया है। इस कार्यक्रम के अध्यक्ष माननीय डॉक्टर विनायक जी टेंभुर्णीकर, जो केंद्रीय शाखा के अध्यक्ष भी है, उनका मैं मनपूर्वक धन्यवाद व्यक्त करता हूँ आज के कार्यक्रम के लिए। उद्घाटक के स्वरूप में आयन वक्त पर जिम्मेदारी देने के बाद भी तुरंत ही रिस्पांस देकर और हमारे कार्यक्रम यानी अपने कार्यक्रम का उद्घाटन करने के प्रति जिन्होंने तत्परता दिखाई, ऐसे हमारे मार्गदर्शक एवं गुरुवर्य डॉक्टर आशुतोष जी कुलकर्णी सर, इनका भी मैं मनपूर्वक धन्यवाद व्यक्त करता हूँ। इस कार्यक्रम में उपस्थित केंद्रीय वुमेन्स फोरम क्या के अध्यक्ष मैडम साधना कुलकर्णी मैडम, उनका उनका भी मैं धन्यवाद व्यक्त करता हूँ। और इसी तरह पूरे महाराष्ट्र के नीमा का जो प्रतिनिधित्व करते हैं, हमारे महाराष्ट्र नीमा के अध्यक्ष डॉक्टर सुहाजी जाधव, उनका मैं प्रातिनिधिक स्वरूप में पूरे महाराष्ट्र के नीमा के सदस्यों की तरफ से और नीमा के सदस्य होने के जिम्मेदारी से उनका भी धन्यवाद व्यक्त करता हूँ। आज के कार्यक्रम का उद्घाटन जो हो रहा है, इस कार्यक्रम में उपस्थित अभी 310 जो मेंबर है उनमें से हमारे आज के कार्यक्रम के जो हमारी टीम है पूरी, इस ज्ञान यज्ञ को आखिर तक जिम्मेदारी से एक अच्छा स्वरूप देने के लिए जो काम कर रहे हैं उन सबका मैं धन्यवाद। आखिर जो कार्यक्रम होगा, सबसे आखिरी में जो कार्यक्रम होगा वहां पर मैं उनके धन्यवाद व्यक्त करूंगा। फिलहाल मैं इस कार्यक्रम में उपस्थित रहने वाले सभी को धन्यवाद व्यक्त करता हूँ और आगे का कार्यक्रम डॉक्टर बाजारे सर डिक्लेयर करेंगे। धन्यवाद धन्यवाद
धन्यवाद डॉक्टर वानी सर। आज का ये उद्घाटन सत्र यहीं पे समाप्त हुआ ऐसा मैं जाहिर करता हूँ। और इसके बाद का जो लेक्चर सीरीज का पहला लेक्चर है वो कार्यक्रम के लिए मैं डॉक्टर अनीता सावंत मैडम, उनको आमंत्रित करता हूँ। आगे का सूत्र संचालन डॉक्टर अनीता सावंत मैडम करेंगी। मैं आपसे अभी विदा लेता हूँ। थैंक यू।
थैंक यू बाजारे सर। वेरी गुड आफ्टरनून टू वन एंड ऑल। व्हाट एन इंफॉर्मेटिव इनॉग्रेशन सेरेमनी वाज दिस, इजंट इट? As said previously, Jnani Yajna is a perfect platform that empowers all of us to upgrade our knowledge and learn practical tools which will help us in our day-to-day practice. After all, true knowledge is the foundation of growth, success, and happiness. Today, we shall start with our first lecture from our Jnani Yajna series. As we all know, pain is an inevitable part of our life. Hence, today's CME deals with the most important concept of our clinical practice, pain management, Ayurveda way. To start with, I request Dr. Rajesh Dhapute sir, coordinator, NIBA Maharashtra State Branch, to give short introduction of our respected dignitary, Dr. Pooja Curley Madam, Associate Vice President, Hem Street Medicare Private Limited. Dr. Rajesh Dhapute sir, over to you. Kindly start it.
Thank you, sir, Anita ma'am, for giving me this opportunity. Dr. Pooja Curley ma'am, Vice President, Hem Street Medicare Private Limited. Pooja ma'am welcomes you on behalf of Zoom participant 3000 plus participant and YouTube 50 participant on YouTube. On behalf of all participant, welcomes you ma'am, and I request you to share your audio visual presentation.
Thank you sir. Thank you. Is it visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Okay. First of all, thanks to Team Nima for giving us this opportunity. मैं आज की जो स्पॉन्सर है हेम स्ट्रीट के बिहाफ से, मैं डॉक्टर पूजा कोहली, हेम स्ट्रीट मेडिकेयर प्राइवेट लिमिटेड वो कंपनी है जो कैनबिस पे काम कर रही है. पिछले कुछ सालों से कैनबिस को लेके बहुत ही एक हमेशा चर्चा में रहा है ये विषय भंगा, जो आयुर्वेद में काफी पहले से उल्लेख तो है लेकिन इस पे रिसर्च नहीं है और कुछ साल पहले बैन भी हो चुका था. अभी अगर हम देखें तो विदेशों में काफी इस पे काम हो चुका है लेकिन हेम्पस्टेड एक पहली कंपनी है जिसने ग्रंथोक्त जो पार्ट है उस पे काम किया है. अभी तक हमारे 3 प्रोडक्ट्स हैं. आज की जो CME है वो पेन मैनेजमेंट पे है तो हमने भी जो काम स्टार्ट किया वो पेन मैनेजमेंट के साथ ही स्टार्ट किया है. जैसे कि ग्लोबल ओपियाइड क्राइसिस को देखते हुए कैनबिस वाज द बेस्ट ऑप्शन. जो अभी क्रॉनिक पेन मैनेजमेंट मार्केट है जो इंडिया में, चाहे वो कैंसर का हो, आर्थराइटिस का हो, फाइब्रोमाइल्जिया या बैक पेन, जो भी पेन्स हैं, इसका बहुत बड़ा मार्केट है. और इसको देखते हुए अभी लोगों ने कैनबिस का अलग अलग तरह से यूज स्टार्ट कर दिया था लेकिन हेम्प स्ट्रीट ने फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल सबसे पहले कुछ प्रोडक्ट्स के साथ आए, त्रैलोक्य विजयावटी, कामेश्वर मोदक एंड बिलवादी चूर्ण, जिसमें से त्रैलोक्य विजयावटी जो है वो स्पेसिफिकली पेन मैनेजमेंट पे काम करती है. हमारा रिसेंटली एक का हमने इम्पैक्ट देखा पोस्ट ऑपरेटिव में, पाइल्स पोस्ट ऑपरेटिव फिशर्स में, जहां पे कि पहले हम पेन किलर्स 15-15 दिन देते थे लेकिन अभी जो हमने केस स्टडी की उसमें ये देखा गया कि 5 दिन हमने उसको रिप्लेस कर दिया त्रैलोक्य विजयावटी से. तो त्रैलोक्य विजयावटी से अच्छे काम हुआ, पेन मैनेज भी हुआ और पेशेंट्स को है वो रिलीफ में मिला और जो साइड इफेक्ट रहते हैं एनाल्जेसिक्स के उससे भी नहीं गुजरना पड़ा. इसके साथ साथ सेकंड प्रोडक्ट है कामेश्वर मोदक जो सेक्सुअल वेलनेस के लिए है. थर्ड प्रोडक्ट अभी हम लॉन्च किया है हमने बिलवादी चूर्ण IBS के लिए. बिलवादी चूर्ण ऑलरेडी मार्केट में बहुत सारे हैं लेकिन जो अभी हमने लॉन्च किया है दैट इज कैनबिस इंक्लूडेड, इसमें भंगा है. और चैट बॉक्स में हम लिंक शेयर करेंगे, अगर किसी को भी सैंपल चाहिए होगा तो वो मिल जाएगा आपके एड्रेस पे. इसके अलावा हमारी केस स्टडी की मैगजीन हम पब्लिश करते हैं क्वार्टरली, जिसमें कि डॉक्टर्स अपने रिव्यूज देते हैं और उससे आपको पता चलेगा कि ये मेडिसिन, क्योंकि भंगा का नाम आते ही हम थोड़ा सा रिस्ट्रिक्टेड हो जाते हैं कि इसको यूज करना है कि नहीं करना, उसके रिव्यूज आपको मिल जाएंगे. और इसके साथ साथ जो हेम्प स्ट्रीट है, अक्सर हमसे डॉक्टर्स पूछते हैं कि इसका साइड इफेक्ट हो जाएगा, ज्यादा ले लेगा पेशेंट, तो ये ब्लॉक चेन मैकेनिज्म के थ्रू काम करता है. हमारे से जो डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन है वो सिर्फ डॉक्टर्स तक होती है, आगे डॉक्टर्स डिस्पेंस करते हैं तो इसलिए वो जो चीज है वो बहुत कम हो जाती है. हेम्पस्ट्रीट का जो पार्टनरशिप है अभी तक CSIR, IIM इनके साथ हुआ है रिसर्च के लिए. NBRI लखनऊ के साथ हमारे रिसर्च प्रोजेक्ट्स चल रहे हैं. इसके अलावा मैं हाईलाइट करना चाहूंगी कुछ हमारे इवेंट्स. ओज फेस्टिवल 2019 एट न्यू दिल्ली, दिस वाज इन एसोसिएशन विद CSIR. देन रिसेंटली हमें बायोटेक्नोलॉजी इग्निशन ग्रांट मिला है. एंड अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट ऑलरेडी जो हमारे करंट डॉक्टर डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन है ये लगभग 5,500 डॉक्टर्स तक पहुंच चुकी है और यूज कर रहे हैं अक्रॉस इंडिया. उसके अलावा हमने रिसेंटली एक इवेंट किया था विमेन्स डे, जिसमें कि डिसमेनोरिया पे, इसका जो स्पेसिफिक त्रैलोक्य विजयावटी का इंडिकेशन था डिसमेनोरिया के लिए, तो उसको ध्यान में रखते हुए विमेन्स डे पे हमने मेडिकल कैंप्स अरेंज किए अक्रॉस इंडिया. तो ये उसके कुछ फोटोग्राफ्स हैं. उत्तर प्रदेश में एक जगह स्कूल में जाके एजुकेट किया डॉक्टर्स ने गर्ल्स को रिगार्डिंग डिसमेनोरिया, मेंस्ट्रुएशन हाइजीन. अभी जो प्रोडक्ट्स हैं इसमें त्रैलोक्य विजयावटी अवेलेबल है, कामेश्वर मोदक अवेलेबल है और कुछ प्रोडक्ट्स हमारे पाइपलाइंस में हैं. ये हमारे डॉक्टर्स हैं, मेडिकल रजिस्टर्ड मेडिकल प्रैक्टिशनर्स जो हैं उनको ही ये मेडिसिन हम देते हैं और उन लोगों की हम केस स्टडीज लेते हैं, रिव्यूज लेते हैं जो बाद में मैगजीन के फॉर्म या हम वेबसाइट कर सकते हैं, आपको केस स्टडीज देंगे. थैंक यू. मैं चैट बॉक्स में अभी एक लिंक शेयर कर दूंगी जिसमें आप अपना फॉर्म फिल कर सकते हैं, यू विल रिसीव द मैगजीन एंड सैंपल्स. थैंक यू डेविड.
थैंक यू मैम फॉर सच अ वैल्यूएबल इंफॉर्मेशन. ओवर टू अनीता मैम.
Thank you, Dr. Pooja Madam, for such a fabulous presentation. And we all hope to be a part of your Chemstream Medical Care Private Institute Limited. And definitely we'll all try these products.
Thank you.
Now let's proceed further in this Nyan Yajna series. I request Dr. Nitin Advani, Treasurer of NEMA WADA Branch, to give introduction of our Honorary Chairperson, Dr. Chandra Kumar Deshmukh sir. Dr. Nitin Advani, sir, over to you.
Thank you, ma'am. Hello, everyone. Good afternoon. I am Dr. Nitin Advani. It gives me an immense pleasure to introduce Dr. Chandra Kumar Deshmukh, sir. He has passed Ayurveda Charya from Government Ayurved College, Nanded, also Dietitian Yoga Charya from Ramtek University, Nagpur, has received gold medal for the same. At present, he is working at Sri Vishwam Maruti Ayurved Chikisale. Also, he has continuous Gokte Sars work on in Agnikarma and Vidagdha at Gokte Memorial Hospital, Pune. Adding credit to his work, he provides free consultation and medicines to more than 200 patients every Wednesday. At Santa Tukaram Maharaj Tirtha Kshetra Dehu. And he, sir, is also awarded with Jivak Award by Himalaya Company. He has received Nanal Puraskar at Pune Tarachan Hospital. Sir has also conducted various karyashalas on Agnikarma Vidagdha Karma in many cities, including Pune and Nanded. My dear delegates, please join me in welcoming sir, whose only motive is to educate every Ayurveda student about this divine reception of Vidagdha and Agnikarma. Please join us and thank you for knowledge inputs with us. Thank you.
Thank you, Nitin sir, for your fantastic introduction of our respected chairperson. I'll request Daga sir. Sir, please make co-host for Monica Patil madam. Okay, now let's proceed further to the most important segment of our Nyan Yajna series. I request Dr. Monica Patil madam, Joint Secretary of NEMA Women's Forum, Kalyan Branch, to give introduction of our respected speaker, Dr. Anaya Patrikar Madam. Monica Patil Madam, are you there? Over to you, Monica Madam.
Right, Madam.
Daga Hello? Sir, please make a co-host. Yeah.
Hello? I'm unable.
Monica. Hello? Yeah. You can start, Madam.
Dr. Anita Patikar, ma'am, has a general academic record. She has topped all university exams while completing his undergraduate and postgraduate in Ayurveda. She is awarded PhD. Her PhD thesis has been awarded as the best thesis award. His research work on mind relaxation therapy for this stress and the PhD for her. Dr. Anaya is the proud author of the 2 books, namely the Hrudyam, the Heart, and the second one is the and Asti Tulasya Bheshaja. These are the 2 books. She is a hardcore academic since 2002. Presently, she is working as a professor and the HOD in Department of Ayurveda Medicine in Mumbai. She is the administrative. She has successfully worked as an assistant and the
Monica Madam, you are not audible to us now. Monica Madam, I think there's some network issue with Monica Madam. So let's proceed further now. Thank you, Monica Madam, for your excellent introduction of a respected speaker. On behalf of my whole NEMA team, I take this golden opportunity to welcome respected Madam Dr. Anaya Patrikar Madam on this platform and request Madam to give us important top and give us guide us on this most important topic, which will definitely help us, that is pain management, Ayurveda way. I request all the participants to please mute yourself. Over to Dr. Anaya Madam. Madam, please kindly start your presentation.
Good afternoon, everyone. And thank you, Anita Madam. Today is the first, what we can say is Prathama Pushpa, first lecture in this particular Jnana Yajna series. And I really thank NEMA for such a nice platform and such a nice team to enrich knowledge of Ayurveda for our Ayurvedic practitioners and new students also. Today, we are going to start with this particular lecture. And in this lecture, let me admit first only that when topic was given to me, I was in little pain because I was knowing that my colleagues, my teachers and my students, in fact, my well-wishers will really wonder whether Ayurveda will have any painkiller or pain management as such. So definitely it's a little difficult topic, but once we understand the concept how Ayurveda manages pain, probably it will be very easy for us. Now, all of us know that pain is a sensation, right? And that's why what is mentioned in Ayurveda is Sukha Saudhnyakam Arogyam Vikaro Dukkham Evacha. So it's the sensation of sukha or comfort and sensation of dukkha or pain, which leads or which is reflection of arogya or vyadhita avastha, that is disease condition. So now today in this particular lecture, we are trying to discuss, I would definitely say discuss, because there are many practitioners who have a very good knowledge of Ayurveda. So let's have about how we can manage pain in by Ayurvedic treatment as well as Ayurvedic therapy. Let me share my screen with you all. Once the screen is visible, please let me know.
Yes, it is, madam.
It is visible, madam.
Okay, fine. Thank you. So here we are, and we start today's lecture, pain management, Ayurvedic way. Now, this particular thing, when we see the topic pain management, let us discuss about two different pain. One is a joint pain and one is chest pain. So where can actually Ayurveda help us, whether in chest pain or whether in joint pain? All of us know that chest pain is very serious, chest pain is very alarming, chest pain is very acute, and chest pain is life-threatening as well, many a times, not though not every time. And whereas if we think about joint pain is chronic pain, is life-threatening pain. So what we will try to understand in today's discussion is how we can help in management of chest pain, as well as how we can conquer chronic pain like joint pain. So let us first understand the concept of pain or shula, which is mentioned in Ayurveda. The way I just now said, pain is unpleasant sensory and emotional experience. Why it is said as emotional experience? Unless and until emotions are attached to that particular sensation, it won't have its exacerbations and complete picture. So it is associated with acute or potential tissue damage. If we remember, on second National Ayurveda Day, Ministry of Ayush has stressed upon this alarming topic, and it has mentioned the theme that pain management through Ayurveda. So now we can understand that this is the theme or this is the need of the hour. And so again, it is responsibility of ISM practitioners, Ayurveda practitioners as well. if you want to classify the pain, then the way I said, pain can be acute, subacute, and chronic, depending upon the duration. Pain can be nociceptive pain and neuropathic pain, psychogenic pain, for example, oncological pain, which is totally unbearable, and pain asymbolia, like diabetic neuropathic pain. If we have to classify pain as per the treatment plan, then neuropathic pain is generally managed with opioid analgesics. Muscle pain is managed with muscle relaxants. Inflammatory pain and mechanical or compressive pain is managed through non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. And sometimes they are supplemented with anxiolytics. This I am talking about management through modern medicine. Now, how we can replace Ayurvedic therapies or Ayurvedic treatments for all such things, that we will have to see here. Concept of Shula in Ayurveda is mentioned as, it's a piercing sensation. Kahitari tochlya sarkhya janavana. Another important thing or another important nirukti about Shula is, it is shankha sphotanavat, that pain or this particular sensation is so severe. Now there Ayurveda believes that nahi vatena vina vedana, means unless and until there is vitiation of vat, there won't be any sensation of pain. So all of us know that vata vitiation occurs by two ways. First thing is dhatu kshayanya vata. Please don't get afraid that I won't be going into very deep details of the theory. We will come to practicality only. But to understand practical approach very well and quickly, we need the basic knowledge. So we just have brief discussion about this particular thing. So dhatu kshayajanya vata prakop, which is because of increased catabolism, or what we can say is chronic degenerative disorders, and margavrodhajanya vata prakop, it is basically because of srotasa avrodh or channel obstruction. For example, chest pain because of coronary blockages. Now, this particular pain sensation is mainly attributed to two characters of vata. One character is Tikshana, Ruksha, three characters, Tikshana, Ruksha, and Chala. Now, this particular sensation, why Chala Guna is also important, because we say the see the patients who are having radiating pain, and in all such things, pathology is at one place, pain is sensed at other place. So this particular chala guna of vata and tikshana guna of vata, they are basically responsible for any pain, especially acute pain. So the way Ayurveda tells us, if we use vyatyasa chikitsa, that is treatment with opposite characters of these two, then definitely we will get pain relief. So tikshana, ruksha, and chala. So treatment plan will be, for tikshana, it will be mrudu or snigdha, or ruksha will be ardra, and for chala, it will be sthira. Now, what is needed for systematic and systemic therapies for this particular pain? We will be differentiating Ayurvedic modalities into two parts. One is acute pain management, and another one will be the management of pain in a systemic way. The way I already said, Shula Chikitsa is Vata Chikitsa. If Vata is treated, ultimately there will be Vedana Shanti or Shula Shanti. Now, what are the Shula Pradhana Vyadhi? Means diseases which we come across who have the pain as prominent symptom. So the, what we can say, the power area of Ayurveda is Sandhi Shula, another is Parinama Shula, and Annadrava Shula. We can attribute them to acute abdominal pain. Then Shiro Roga, Suryavarta, Anantavat, Shankhaka, Ardhava Vedaka, Grudrasi or sciatic or sciatic pain, Avabahuka, Vishwachi, Aunsa Graha, Aunsa Shosha, Mutra Krucha, that is acute ureteric colic, Tuni and Pratituni, And another group is Udavarta, Gulma, Anah, Adman, Ato, which are related with the digestive disturbances. Now, what is mentioned in Ayurveda is, what is general line of treatment of Shula? If we are going by systemic way, then it will be Shodhan, then Snehan Swedan, then Langhan or Pach and Pachan. And last line is most important, treatment of Shula with Amla, Lavana, Kshara, Katu and Ushna Dravya. So when we will be seeing the table of the drugs which are useful as a Shulagna Dravya, all of you can correlate this particular thing that Amla, Lavana, Katu and Kshara and Ushna property drugs are best Shulagna drugs. Now, if we want to manage the particular Shula, now see, here are, I have enlisted some common pain which we come across in our patients or in ourselves also. We can see that it is joint pain, abdominal pain or colic, headache, dysmenorrhea, ureteric colic, urethrasy, chest pain. Okay. General pathology, underlying pathology for pain can be categorized as inflammatory, vascular, spasmodic or colicky, neurological, neuromuscular, musculoskeletal and muscular. Now, here I would like to discuss a little bit that when we need to manage pain in instant, for instant pain relief or pain management of acute pain, what are the things those which we have with us? Those things are sthanika chikitsa or localized treatment which are directed towards the pain site and which help for giving instant and quick pain relief. I'll skip some slides. We'll go quickly to the slide which I want to show all of you. And then we will come back again for system management. See, this is the slide which is which you can see that it's a therapy given for acute pain and it is termed as Agni Karma, right? So Agni Karma will be helpful for intense, acute, localized pain, maybe because of degenerative pathology or inflammatory pathology. But in such cases, what is essential is we need to understand that Agni Karma will give quick pain relief. Agni Karma will relieve spasm or spasticity or what we can say, symptoms like frozen shoulder or movements are constricted or restricted. All such things will be relieved quickly, but this cannot cure the pain. So this is pain management and acute pain management. Now this Agni Karma is one of the most effective parasurgical procedure mentioned for management of pain, which is done with the help of chalk or metal probe. This particular treatment, the way we have just discussed about musculoskeletal, neuromuscular, muscular pain and other origins of the pain. So this Agni Karma is most useful in Parshani Shula, that is heel pain because of calcaneal spur, Sandhigata Vata or osteoarthritis, and Avabahu or frozen shoulder. Now, how this Agni Karma works? Probably we won't be going into details of this action of Agni Karma. Why? Because it is basically of academic interest. Still, what we need to understand in short is the local stimulation is given with the Agni Karma and ultimately it gives pain relief. Now, this is another treatment. Now, whenever Deshmukh sir is there as chairperson and me talking about Vidha Chikitsa is definitely not acceptable. So I will keep this particular part for our chairperson only whenever he gives comments on the lecture in particular. But still, let us get introduced with the concept of Vidha Chikitsa. This Vidha Karma is again of two types, Vidha and Vidhagni. In Vidha Karma, this is again a parasurgical procedure where marma or vital points of the body are taken into consideration. And piercing of needles leads to painful mechanical stimulus, which causes release of endorphins, thereby causing immediate pain relief.
The another procedure wherein Agni Karma and Vidha Karma are combined together is called as Vidhagni, and it is also helpful in painful condition, and it gives very good instant pain relief. Now this is again a third treatment which gives instant relief, and that is Rakta Mokshan. Now Rakta Mokshan, in this picture you can see it is been done with Jalauka or leash therapy, but Rakta Mokshan by Siraved also helps equally and instantly and potently in case of Shula Chikitsa. In Rakta Mokshan, Siraved helps very well in Grudrasi. Nowadays, many people are using cupping therapy for pain relief, especially at the swollen and tender joints. So, Siraved, Jalaukavacharan, cupping-like treatments will give good relief because of, see, there is accumulation of rakta, dosha, means dushita rakta, and once that is removed from that, what happens is vata can move freely, and so obstruction for vata is removed, and so once there is vata anuloman, that is proper flow of vata and other material, then pain will be relieved. So Rakta Mokshan also gives instant pain relief. Another pain relief treatment, and that also localized treatment or external therapy we can say, is of lepa chikitsa or local application of medicated pests on the skin. Now this is useful in again intense and acute pain related with the joints, related with the muscles, as well as other body organs. Specifically useful in vata rakta, tuvaka gata vata, vrana shotha, that is inflammatory conditions, Mausa Gatava and Snayu Gatava. Now here we use two types of lepa, that is pralepa and pradeha. One is having sheetha characters and other is having ushna characters. Now this particular difference, pralepa and pradeha, is made so as to ensure, see, all of us understand one pathology of acute inflammatory changes, that there is collection of the blood at particular site. In some patients or in some conditions, if we only apply ushna lep, what will happen? That particular vrana shoth may advance to the from pachyamanavastha to the pakvavastha, and vidradi formation can be there. But in some cases, what is essential is, rather than vidradi formation, if we can control the pachyamanavastha and revert it back, then there will be shotha and shula shamana. So as per the symptoms of the patient and as per condition, localized condition, we have to decide whether we want to use pralepa chikitsa or pradeha chikitsa. Now, after these local and instant treatments, what we will be seeing is how the pain can be managed in systematic way. So let us think about it. Management of shul, pain relief, not cure. Pain relief can be achieved by instant and symptomatic treatments. But if we are aiming at pain cure, then we need to give gradual therapies, and treatment should be done for the particular vyadhi so that associated pain will also be relieved with the vyadhi upashaya. Already we have discussed little bit about the sthanik or local treatment. Now we will be seeing in detail about antaparimarjan or shamana chikitsa as well. Now Charak and Vaghbhat have mentioned the group of drugs which are useful for particular impaired sensation. Now, why I'm saying so? Because Charaka has mentioned these drugs, you can see in the slide, that these drugs are Daha Prashaman. Now, generally we feel that why Daha Prashaman drugs are to be seen when we are thinking about the pain management. But burning sensation or burning pain is also one type of pain, generally which we see in neuropathy and neuritis. If you all of us know that herpes zoster, severe burning sensation, diabetic neuritis, again severe burning sensation of palms and soles, and other diseases also wherein there can be tevra daha or burning sensation. So in such conditions or in such sort of a pain, chandana, madhuka, nilotpala, these are the different types of kamala, ushir, sariva or anantamur, guduchi, kala vala or vibera, nimba, durva, draksha, vasa, bhunimba, amalaki, shatavari, vidari, pravala, ikshu, kharjura, kshira, navnita, gruta. See, the the items mentioned, laja, ikshu, kharjur, kshira, navnita, gruta and sharkara are dietary items which needs to be taken in more amount. Obviously, kharjur and sharkara is not allowed in diabetic patient, but in other patients where pitta vitiation has led to daha or burning sensation, this is the diet and the group of drugs which I have narrated earlier can be chosen. Appropriate drugs can be chosen and given to patient for daha prasham. Instant relief can be achieved with the generally apply Kailash Jivan or Shatadhuta Ghruta or Gairika and Ghruta for Daha Prashaman also. These drugs can be consumed orally also to get relief from the burning sensation. Then Sheeta Prashaman, whenever there is increased sensation or perceptibility that cold sensation is there. What are the drugs of option? Tagara, Agru, Shunki, Ajamoda, Vacha, Kantakari, Agnimantha, Pippali, Sarshap or Rajika. Now, here what we can think is whenever there is a small kid, newborn child, whenever that child is given a bath, after that what mother or the caretaker does to that particular child is powder application of vacha, that is vekhanda and shunti, is done all over body of that particular child. When we grow up, we use different sorts of talcum powders or deos and perfume. But for babies especially, this particular powder application is being done to protect the baby from sheetha and to keep the body warm. So whenever there is sheetha sensation, these drugs can be used. Now next, Angamarda Prashamana. What is meant by Angamarda Prashamana? All of us know that whenever there is severe body ache, ideal drug can be Sudarshan Ganavati or Tribhuvan Kirti and Ananda Bhairav. But if we want to use only herbal drugs and not herbo-mineral combinations, then this particular combination or this gana, all the drugs in this particular gana in combination can be given. And drugs are Vidari, Eranda, Krushniparani, Bruhati, Kantakari, Kapoli, Chandan and Rakta Chandan, both of them are mentioned. But Rakta Chandan is more useful, Ushira, Vatsanabha, Tulsi and Shunki. In my practice, what I have seen is Tulsi is very good drug for Angamarda Prashamana and gives very good results and quick results. So Tulsi, Shunki and this thing, Kantakari, if given together, will give very good results in body ache. In general, Shula Prashamana. Now you can see two group of drugs. One is Shula Prashamana and another is Vedana Sthapan. What is the difference between Shula and Vedana, which Acharya want to convey to us? One is little restricted to the digestive disturbances and abdominal pain. And another one is spread over the wide aspect or wide range, that is muscular pain. So in Shula Prashamana, what we can see is Deepana Pachana drugs or digestion promoting drugs and drugs which improve the Vata Anuloman. So Panchakolasa or Panchakol Churna can be the best choice. Drugs are narrated here, Pippali, Pippali Mula, Chavya Chitraka, Shunti, Maricha, Ajmoda, Ajagandha, Jiraka. What is most favorite drug of all Ayurvedic practitioners, either Hingvashta Churna or Shankavati, right? But apart from that, Ajamodadi Churna, Shadharana Churna also can help to get give very good results in case of abdominal pain. Next group is Vedana Sthapanagana. So whatever drugs are repeated, I will not read them again. But drugs like Vachavatsana, Ashoka, Lodhra, Shirisha, Ahifen, I would now, with the permission of the sponsor, I would again like to introduce or include Vijaya or Bhanga in this particular group, because which is a very good Vedana Sthapanagana. You will see that particular drug in the tabular form where I have mentioned it. Now, Vagbhat has mentioned different gana for particular four sensations. One is pain sensations only. One is Mutra Kruchra or ureteric colic. It is Parushakadi, Viratharadi and Ushakadi gana. These four are available and so we can use them in our daily practice. In Gulma, Vatsakadi, Vidaryadi and Varunadi, whenever there is sensation of bloating sensation, pain in abdomen, restlessness, all such symptoms can be relieved with these gana. And Urustambha, severe pain sensation in the thigh region, Vachadi and Haridradi gana. Vachadi and Haridradi gana are again useful for dyslipidemia as well. Now here I have enlisted some of the common drugs, single herbs, which are useful as sort of painkiller or analgesics. Now why these are categorized in this particular fashion? Because if you go through the first column of the table, then the drugs which are mentioned are especially useful in musculoskeletal disorders. And so the drugs are Rasna, Dashamur, Punarnava, Nirgundi, Shallaki, Shunti, Gugul and Erandam. All these drugs, whenever given in pain related with muscles and bones or joints, will give very good results. Now, which drug is to be used and when is to be used? I would love to give details of all these things, but time won't permit me for that. So, just remember, these drugs together or in isolation will definitely give very good pain relief in musculoskeletal pain. Another group of drugs, third column, is Sarpagandha, Tagar, Dhatura, Ahifena, Bhanga, Khurasni Ova or Parasik Yavani, Jatamausi and Gunja. Here it's a mixture of sedatives, tranquilizers as well as painkillers. But many of drugs mentioned in this particular group are termed as Visha or Upavisha by Ayurveda. So they should be used after proper purification only. But these are all fantastic painkillers. I would directly use the word painkillers or analgesics. And when used, they give really very good results with the sort of analgesia and anesthesia because of its sedative effect as well. Now, fourth column is a group of drugs, Vidanga, Panchakola, Methika, Ajmoda, Shatapushpa, Rason, Ardrak, Ativisha, and all of you can conclude that this group is useful for abdominal pain, digestive disturbances, or what we can say is Annavaha and Purishvaha Srotas Vikruti and pain related with those organs, hollow organs. Now another group, second column is Ela, Lavanga, Vacha, Tvak, Nadi Hingu, Karpura, and Maricha. If you see, these all drugs are aromatic drugs. And so their aromatic drugs again give very good relief for the localized pain. It can be toothache, earache, or other sort of localized pain. Another group or last column is includes Shankha, Shautik, Kapardik, Pravar, Murud, Sheng, Lavan and Bilva. This is little a dicey group. Why it is so? Because I want to stress upon one thing. Whenever diet or drugs are given with Amla and Lavana ras or characters, they use means they are useful for Vata Anuloman or proper gati or motion movement of Vata and will ultimately give the pain relief. Murud Sheng or Avartani, all of us know it is one of the important or compulsory drug of the Balaguti. Why? Because Balaguti is ideal combination of different pain sensation, as baby cannot tell us what particular organ is paining or what sort of pain baby is going through. But it contains Murud Sheng and other drugs, Haridaki, Jatiphal and other baby's pain sensation without baby telling us. So this is in short about the common drugs which we can use as per the need. Now, what I would like to do, this is obviously my area of interest being Ayurvedic physician. We will try to understand how pain in joint can be managed. And so such sort of basic understanding about the pain can be applied to other pains as well. And one can do treatment of pain in a very successful way. The way we have already seen that joint pain can be because of degenerative arthritis, inflammatory arthritis, musculoskeletal pain, bursitis, synovitis, neuromusculoskeletal pain. So for all such things, what is required is we need to understand the anatomy of sandhi or joint. Again, no details or academics. But please try to understand, this is very important. Every time the particular pain in joint is not because of the bones, right? But it is more because of the attachments or associated structures which are there in the joint. So kandara, what is function of kandara? Movement, that is extension and flexion. What is shira? The structure, again understand tendon, ligaments, bursa, menisci, all almost are included here. What is mentioned is sandhi bandhana karinyo. The one which gives proper strength to sandhi is sandhi bandhana karini shira, kurcha, where snayu and dhamani will come together, especially they are in griva, kaksha, vamshana, bhageshu. So if it is like sacroiliitis, it is like frozen shoulder, then we have to think about treatment of snayu and not only every time gugul, gugul, gugul. Because we, even academicians, many a times while treating patients in associated hospitals, tend to generally write gugul for joint pain. Why? Because that is easily available and at our dispensary, and so patient gets relief because it contains gugu and other drugs. But if we want to really be specific about the particular pain, then my friends, please remember this particular slide. It will help you in the long run. Then next is jala or bursa type structures, where mausa, sira, snayu, asthi all have come together. So where can we find all such things? Manibandha and gulpa, which are locomotory joints, but which have little complex structure. Okay, so what is what needs to be understood is, suppose there is a knee joint pain and suppose there is a wrist joint pain. Kindly think which particular thing, kandara, shira, mausa, snayu, which particular thing has got more affected, and accordingly you can modify your drugs. I always tell my students also that whenever we are using gugul for vata vyadhi or especially joint pain, think about your pizza. It's like a gugul is like a pizza base, so which is a compulsory ingredient. Now, it is up to that particular physician and he has to decide as per the symptoms in patient and condition and clinical examination, which pizza toppings you want on that particular gugul. So gugul is a base and it is up to us what we will be adding to that gugul to give better results in lesser time and lesser number of medicines as well as less dose of the medicine. So if this particular slide everyone remembers, I guess you yourself can decide whether to add rasna, whether to add nirgundi or only dashamu or some dhatu bhasma to the gugul and give it to the patient to get best of the results for the sandhi vedana or sandhi shula. Now, what is generalized treatment for shula or sandhi shula? All of us know Snehan, Swedan, Agni Karma, Vedhan Karma, Rakta Mokshan, Lepan Karma. So localized treatments we have already covered. Now proper localized treatments are more towards the parasurgical procedures. So my interest, obviously being Kai Chikitsa, will be Vasti Karma and Shamana Chikitsa. Now the last two treatments, Sattva Vajaya Chikitsa, that is psychological interventions and lifestyle intervention and yoga therapy. Why it is essential? Because once patient has osteoarthritis of knee joint or chronic Janus of the shoulder, and whenever doctors tell that you have to do knee replacement for both your knee joints, what is happening is, just a minute, internet. What is required is that particular patient goes in deep depression. So it is not only taking care of the physical pain, but it should be the psychological care also, or psychological pain. Je ki patient cha manala vait vatlela hai ani tithe dukhte te pan treat karna tevadhach avashyak hai, then only you will get the best of the results. Psychological elements once are involved will not give complete relief if only physical elements are treated. So these two treatments are mentioned. Now in Snehan we have two different ways. One is Bahya Snehan, which can be done with Abhyanga, Mardana, Parisheka. What is Parisheka? If any joint is quite stiff and painful, severe pain and stiffness is there, then only application can't help the patient. Apart from that, sometimes it is impossible to apply oil on the joint because joint is so tender that patient will not allow you to touch the joint. So in such conditions, Parisheka or Dhara at that particular joint, manje koshna tel je ahe, lukewarm oil je ahe, tya oil chi continuous pouring of that oil on the particular affected joint till that particular stiffness as well as pain and tenderness is relieved, is what is essential. Sthanik pichu also can help in such sort of conditions. Now another treatment is Sneha Abhyanga, where gentle application of force can be done. Now the way earlier we have thought that it is Dhatu Kshaya Janya and Marga Avrodha Janya. So whenever degenerative changes are the underlying cause for the pain, drug of choice or oil of choice for Abhyanga will be Bala, Chandan Bala Laksha, Ashwagandha, Bala Ashwagandha Tel, Shatakshir Bala, Narayan Tel, Mahanarayan Tel, Mahamasha Tel, Shatavari Tel. All these oils will help for boosting up the snayu, or what we can say, Shleshaka Kapha in that particular joint, and will take care of the degeneration. But it won't be achieved within 7 to 10 days. It should be Nirantara Abhyas. It should be done as a regular practice. And then only patient will get good relief. But if we want instant pain relief, then Sahachar Tel or Nirgundi Tel can be better options and can be used for acute inflammatory and tender joints as well as degenerative joint diseases. Then if there is acute pain and inflammation along with tenderness, then the Vishagarbha, Kashmul Siddha Rasona, Moolakadi or plain Rasona Tel, Pinda Tel, Saindhavadi Brihat Tel, and if severe stiffness and lack of movements is there, means movements are frozen, then Prasarani Tel can be a very good option. Now, apart from all these oils, nowadays, even I use many liniments in combination with the oils. Why liniments are better choice than oil? Because liniments have quick and better penetration, and pain relief is achieved within minutes. So if we make liniment along with oil, then it will give better results. These are some of the pictures how local application or local retention of oil can be done on the joint to relieve muscle spasms as well as to release vata where it is being accumulated. Now, second treatment is Swedana. which is very useful because in Sweden it is said that stambha, that is frozenness or stiffness, gaurava, that is heaviness in the joint, sheetagnam, coldness in the joint. So stambha gaurava sheetagnam swedagnam swedanam swedakarakam. This swedan can be done bahya as well as abhyantara. Abhyantara swedan is generally, means drugs for swedan orally generally are given in jwara, but we can use them for amavata conditions or amavata shul also. In bahya swedan, what is done is local application of heat. Till now, I have highlighted one line that physiotherapy always prefers ice massage as the painful joint, right? Whenever I was working earlier with D.Y. Patil, we always used to have this difference of opinion that we used to advise Snehan Swedan to the patient and physiotherapists generally used to advise ice massage to the patient. And patients used to get confused. And now, research itself has proved that if ice then body's natural response for the healing is delayed. And so even now physiotherapists have come up with this particular acceptance of the therapy that rather than ice massage, let the joint swell after the injury so that more and more blood supply is there and local repair of the pathology is also stimulated or fastened. So now what is required is for swedana, we can use n number of things. I will show that particular slide also. And whenever we want to have abhyantara swedana, then vatsanabha, tulsi, hingula, vacha, and agaru can be used in these patients to give good pain relief and relief from the stiffness as well. Agni karma, vidha karma, rakta mokshan. Hello, am I audible clear?
There's slight disturbance in between, madam. Rest your order.
Okay. Okay, fine. Thank you. Because even I was just checking. Thank you, madam. Now, important drugs or formulations which can be used for joint pain are, all of us know, Google is very ideal and nice drug which we use in abundance. And apart from Google, the ideal analgesics or painkillers are Ballataka. In Amavata patient also, to give them good relief from particular pain and stiffness, what is required is Ballataka beach wrapped in cotton can be kept at the palm and sole of the patient while patient is sleeping. The heat from that Ballataka beach, heat from that particular Ballataka beach gives very good amapachan effect, and whatever morning stiffness is there in the patient and pain is there, that is relieved if such sort of Ballataka can be used. Panchakol, Hingu, Dashmul, Gunja are other drugs which can be used. In herbal combinations, Vata Vidhvams, Vishatindu, Suvarna Kalpa, Vata Gajankush, Suvarna Rajvangeshwar, Shrunga Basma also can be given. I sincerely feel, I have mentioned Kwatha, that is Dashmul, Eranda, Rasna, Nirgundi, Dhatradi, and Haritakyadi Kwath, but still, if patient is not having any hyperacidity or amla and sort of gastric disturbances, then better to start with asava or arishta, as they are sadhana kalpas of what we can say only preparation. Their pain killing action is better than plain simple kwatha. So asava arishta are to be preferred over the kwatha. Now, basti, all of us know that Ayurveda has mentioned about basti treatment for joint pain. But whenever we come to basti, different varieties of basti. But see, basti chikitsa, when it is for vatanuloman, will give instant relief. But basti chikitsa is done regularly, periodically, and for longer duration, it will give fantastic results in degenerative arthritic pain. especially we have done clinical trials on Majjabasti and Usarasabasti, and patient gets very good relief. Another drug trial was done, last time I have mentioned in this slide, that Churnabasti for 3 to 5 days. Whenever patient comes to us with severe multiple joint pain associated with stiffness and little swelling also, we start with the, means generally we give first basti as shodhan, first we give oral pachan drug, and then we give churna basti of shadharan or vaishvanara churna, and that relieves the stiffness in the joints, and then we start with yoga basti kram for the patient. Sthanik chikitsa, all of us know, what can be the best, easiest sthanik or local treatment? Just take handful of amount of salt, wrap it into the cotton, just heat it on the pan and apply on the joint, and one will get instant pain. We have if we are having severe indicoduation.
Sorry to interrupt, madam. Hello, madam. Hello. Madam, there's slight disturbance. We can't hear you properly. There's slight noise disturbance in between. Your voice gets cut off in between.
Okay. What I will
it's not do audible is, clearly.
I don't know. Just a minute. Can I... just a minute. I will stop my video and continue with the screen sharing, and let me know if the audio or voice quality is better.
Okay, ma'am.
Can we proceed, madam?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you so much. So whenever there is muscle pain or myalgia, what generally we do is lukewarm water, added salt, and we dip our leg, avagaha sveda, and that gives very good result in relief of the pain. Now, this particular sthanik chikitsa, whenever we are doing, will give very good results. My slide show is not going on. I'm really sorry. Yeah, now this is again a list of the drugs which are useful for pain relief. Vedana sthapana, vedana shamaka gan, herbo mineral combinations, and gugul also. We have discussed sufficient about it. General drugs which can be useful. Here I would like to mention one thing about Vata Vidhams and Bruhat Vata Chintamani. Many students has this particular query that where to use these drugs. Bruhat Vata Chintamani is a drug of choice for Dhatu Kshayajanya Vata Prakop, that is severe degenerative disease, and especially if that particular disease is in thin and lean patients. And Vata Vidhams is a drug which can be given in Vata Kaphaja ailments, wherein there is little amount of swelling or inflammatory changes, and patient is also having Vata Kaphaja Prakruti. So this is the difference between where we can use Bruhat Vata Chintamani and Vata Vidhams. My experience tells me that Vishatindu gives very good painkilling result in joint disorders. Samir Pandagi is the drug to be kept reserved for the Amavad because it gives very good result in Amavad. Now, this particular slide where I have mentioned that about the Pachana Chikitsa, if we are treating, giving only Basti, only Sthanik Lepa or Abhyanga, it won't work. Unless and until Ama Pachan is achieved, Vatanuloman will not be there. So these are 4 popular drugs which should be given simultaneously, side by side, orally to any patient who is suffering from pain. Because these element, these combinations have Vedana Shaman and Shula Shaman property as well as Ama Pachana property also. So Shadharan, which is a drug for the abdominal pain, panchasam churna, vaishvanar churna, again very good drug for amapachan, and himashtak churna, which is a very good drug for vata anulomana. So as per patient's choice and availability, one of these four drugs should be definitely given for pachana chikitsa along with any vata chikitsa in management of pain. Now, if patient is having some sort of acidity or other symptoms, this particular churna can be given with gruta anupan so that patient will not have hyperacidity. For joint pain, the way I have already said, n number of gugula are enlisted here, yograj, kaishor, tripala, trayodashanga. Again, for good pain killing activity, trayodashanga gugula can be the choice of the drug. But the way I told you, one should decide as per the patient's requirement and add the drugs and make the particular combination. Then oils also, we have already discussed about pinda tail and muruvenna tail. Muruvenna tail and panchaguna tail have very good pain killing or vata shamana activities. Muruvenna tail is especially useful if the particular muscular pain is after a lot of muscle movements and muscle exercises, then muruvenna tail is more useful to here is one trifala virechan, that is trifala quat one part and eranda sneha two parts. And what can be added to this particular combination? Either gomutra or madh, that is makshika, dugdha or mausarasa, depending upon patient's bala and vyadhi bala. For virechan and vatanuloman, for which type of particular pain? Parshvashul, kukshishul, katishul, and koshthashul. So this particular combination, generally we tend to give eranda sneha with shunthi kwat, but if it is given with trifala kwat, it will give better results. These are some of the clinical successful clinical trials which we have done in our hospital. I would like to narrate one or two of them. One of my PG student has done work with this combination named Amavata Gajasiha Modak. It is the drug which is having very good combination of Amapachaka drugs as well as Vatanulomana drugs. And this is particularly useful for chronic rheumatoid arthritis in debilitated patients who are very thin and lean and are suffering from joint disorder, that is rheumatoid arthritis, since long and now are having Swan-Neck deformity or ulnar deviation and joint morbid changes. We have given this drug to those patients and pain sensation was considerably relieved. Another important thing was these patients improved their appetite and they have gained 1 or 2 kg weight in 1 month and patients had very good sensation of well-being. According to me, probably it is because in Amavata, generally we tend to give Sinhana Kukul, Vishatinduk, Agni, Tundi, Vati and all such Ushna Tikshna drugs for longer duration. And we forget that even Dhatu Poshan is essential along with Amapachan. But this particular combination has fantastic results and in our institute, now also we are using this particular Amavata Gajasiha Modak for successful management of chronic rheumatoid arthritis in thin and lean patients. Now, Samir Yograj Mishran is another combination by our senior faculty. It is a combination of Samir Panna, Yograj Gugur and Vata Vidvans, and which gives very good pain relieving action in joint pain. Vishwadi Gugur is another drug which is under trial in our institute. In Sushumna Shul, especially oncogenic pain over the spinal cord, Maida Lakdi Lep is the Sthanik Chikitsa, local application, which is used by respected my guide, respected Sir Deshmukh sir and his team at DSD Research Center. And oncological pain, maybe shoulder pain after removal of axillary lymph nodes, cervical pain after removal of cervical lymph nodes, and all such sort of pain is tackled very well with local application. Obviously, supplemented with oral medicine as well, but this local application result. Now, in brief, I would like to tell you about the Vataja, Pittaja and Kapaja Shul. Why I want to stress upon this thing is, we need to understand if we are seeing this pathology of prolapse, ptosis, displacement, varicosity, dilatation, aneurysm, spasm, porosity, pricking pain, all such pains, types of pain, tremors, then Vaksanga, Malasanga, and morbid changes, Khanjar, Pangulya. It is basically because of Vat. So though we do any other treatment, please never forget to add Vata Shamana Chikitsa in all such conditions, because it will give an additional benefit of taking care of the basic element in the pathology. Now, because of lack of time, I will not go into all these details, Vataj, Pittaja and Kafaja Shul, which I would have loved to discuss in detail. Amaja Shula Chikitsa is basically treatment of abdominal pain. And for that, different drugs are used. And one very nice Aranda Saptaka combination is there, which contains Aranda Mool, Pilva Mool, Bruhati Dvaya, Matulunga, that is Mahalunga, Pashan Bhed, Gokshur Mulakwat, with Prakshep of Kingu, Yavakshar, Saindhava, and Anupan as Erandasnehu. If this particular combination is given for what we can say periumbilical pain or abdominal pain, it gives very good results because of Vata Shaman and Amapachan. Then Ajmodadi, Shurna, Shankhavati and other drugs are always there, which we know. But this Aranda Saptak gives very good results and it is easily available and not very costly also. About Ruchul, only I will say two, three things and then I would like to conclude my session. Won't take it a lot. See, though Rudrok chest pain, many a times it is cardiac pain or pain of cardiac origin. So, I may not suggest that we should manage it only with Ayurvedic medicines. But if a patient is having unstable angina, stable angina, as well as precordial pain, repeated precordial pain with unknown etiology, then probably as Ayurvedic physicians, we need to understand three, four important things about that pain. And supplementation of Ayurvedic drugs along with the modern medicine which patient is already taking is what will give better results and better pain killing action in the patient. So please remember that chest pain, if it is getting aggravated after digestion of food, the way we think about abdominal pain and Parinama Shul, if pain is aggravating after digestion of food and it is of pricking, tearing, breaking, wrapping sensation, then it can be Vataja Shul. So kindly manage Vata along with modern medicine drugs, which a physician has advised. If pain is more during digestion, then Pitta can be the associated vitiated dosha. So Pitta management is essential. And if pain aggravates immediately after intake of food, then Kafaja pathology or association can be thought of and Kapha management can be done. Now, there will be typical features of this particular pain as per the vitiation of dosha, which is mentioned in our text also. Vataja pain will be sort of ayamyate, tudyate, todlyasarkha, odlyasarkha, pilvatlyasarkha, diryate, phadlyasarkha, sphotyate, thoka marun todlyasarkha. That sort of pain will be there. In pitta, daha, amlodgar, klama, murcha, and mukha shosha will be associated symptoms. So, if we see all such symptoms, accordingly, we can treat the underlying dosha and continue with the modern medicinal treatment. In Ruth Shulagna drugs, this can be a wide range of drugs which can help a patient to get, means obviously as associated treatment also, we can use these drugs. In this, Hemagarbha, Lakshmi Vilas, Nardiya Lakshmi Vilas, Mahalakshmi Vilas, Saraswatarishta, Mahavat Vidhams, Bruhatvat Chintamani, Sutshekhar and Suvarna Sutshekhar, Karaskar Kalpa, all these drugs will give very good results if given in proper dosage and after proper clinical examination of the patient. In Ruchul, all of us know that Mrugashunga is very good drug, but it is banned drug, so we should not think about it. But other drugs which can be used are Laghu Sutshekhar, Lakshmi Vilas, and Erandamulpat with Yavakshar. So I would have loved to go in details of this particular time won't permit. Another, within 5 minutes, let us cover about the Shirashul or headache. Shirashul is basically, Shira is the area where lot of holes are there, right? So it is like ears, nose or nostrils, then mukha, and then eye sockets also. So whenever patient has chronic Shirashul, most important treatment is Kapurana, that is Srotasa should be given proper good amount of snehana so that vata balancing can be there, and as vata is entering into these spaces and causing shula, vata shaman will be achieved and there will be good relief to the patient. So rather than discussing netra tarpan, karna puran, kavala, gandush, nasya, all of us know that nasya gives very good result, but please don't keep yourself limited with nasya therapy only. Try to do karna puran, netra tarpan, kavala gandush and nasya. This will give better relief in Shirashula. Along with that, Shiro Pichu, Shiro Basti, Shiro Abhyanga, Shiro Dhara with various vata shaman oil or only Shiro Abhyanga also will help in all such conditions. So this is the theme of treatment. Choice of drug can depend as per the physician choice as well as clinical examination of the patient. This is about the Pathya Pathya. I will not go into the details of Pathya Pathya. Yoga therapy, relaxation, pranayam and meditation will always help in any sort of Vedana. So that is what is essential. This is a quick checklist to check whether we are swastha or not. Now, next slide is most important for me and of interest of all my colleagues. See, it cannot be this way that Anaya madam is having headache, so she is taking Prozin and delivering lecture on pain management Ayurveda way. So it is equally important for our hectic, in our hectic schedule, we ourselves also should be pain-free always and always energetic to serve the mankind. And for that, what is essential is we should undergo proper, regular, periodic shodhana. It should be this way, that the way females have regular parlor visit, it should be a regular panchakarma unit visit to keep ourselves swastha and keep our tridosha pacified so as to have pain-free life. So with these words, I would like to conclude my thoughts on the pain management. And at the end, I would like to thank NEMA officials. I'm grateful to all office bearers of NEMA, Maharashtra state, for organizing this Jnana Yajna. The way Jnaneshwar Maharaj has said in his Pasaya Dan, Ata Vishwatmake Deve, I would like to say, Ata Dhanvantari Deve, Yene Jnana Yajna Toshave, Ani Sagyanna Arogya Dana Dyave. So this Jnana Yajna webinar series for updating knowledge of ISM practitioners. I'm thankful to Dr. Tembhulnikar sir, national president, and Dr. Kulkarni sir, treasurer of Central Council, who are backbone and the driving force of NEMA, both at state and national level. I'm thankful to Dr. Deshmukh for this particular session. I extend my thanks to organizers of this webinar series, Dr. Vishnu Bhavani sir, former MCM member, for giving me this opportunity to share my insight on this particular topic. Last but not least, I'm thankful to sponsor of this lecture, entire organizing committee of this webinar, anchor, technical team, and all the participants who attended this event and participated in this Jnana Yajna. I always feel proud to be a member of NEMA family, one of the oldest and largest NGO working for the betterment of ISM practitioners nationwide, especially for protecting the rights of integrated practice. Thank you, one and all. Jai NEMA, Jai Ayurveda.
Thank you, madam, for such an outstanding and phenomenal information. Agni Karma, Raptamokshan, Lepa Chikitsa, Shaman Chikitsa, management of pain, psychological chikitsa, Jai Sthanik Pichu, Parishaik, Basti Chikitsa, Augaha. This all therapies will definitely help us in our day-to-day practice. So I thank you, madam, once again for such an information given to us. Now let's move ahead with the most awaited part of the series, that is question answer series. To avoid chaos, I've requested all the participants to ask their queries in the chat box, and each query will be definitely answered one by one. Madam, I'll ask the first question. That was asked by Dr. Swapna Das, how to manage fibromyalgia in old age. Hello, madam. Am I audible?
Yeah. Can you hear me, madam?
Yes, madam.
Yes. Fibromyalgia in old age or younger age, both will have the same pathology, but symptoms will be more in old age, obviously. As the name suggests, there are fibrous changes in the elastic tissue as well as there is severe muscular pain. So in such cases, if pain is localized, then use of portally sway, patra portally sway or only portally sway will give better results, and sthanik sneham and swedan will be helpful. For oral medication, I would suggest that vata vidhams and paraskar kalpa should be given to the patient. For pain management, here as we are focusing mainly on pain management, I will not be suggesting anything to take care of the vyadhi or vyadhi prashaman. But only for pain management, Vata Vidhams, Vishatinduk will really help. And along with that, if patient is very thin and lean, I sincerely feel Kapikachu and Ashwagandha will also work wonders in these patients.
Thank you, madam. Madam, the next question was asked by Dr. Madhuri Kharat. Okay, instead of grit, what can be used? I think it's related to amvat. Amvat mane bhuta pandit nahi mohi vicharla hai prashn.
Right. In Ayurveda, there are four basic sneha. That is gruta, taila, vasa and majja. Generally, what we say is for local application, we prefer oils. For oral consumption, being dietary material, gruta is preferable, and vasa and majja are kept for the specific conditions wherein agni should be very good and patient should have very good agni and dhatvagni bala, then only vasa and majja pan can be advised. But if gruta is to be avoided, see, it can be replaced this way, that very less quantity of gruta along with poshna jala can be used. And if gruta is to be totally avoided, if possible, same drug can be siddha or processed in oil and can be used for oral as well as local application. But I would like to ask the delegate who has asked this question. She wants to know it about the, in general, gruta is to be avoided or for vegan patients or what it is exactly. Hello.
Madam,
vegan patients. Yeah. for vegan patients. So what can be done is, the way we always do, if we want a very good VAVAI action, means drug should reach the particular area of the body quickly, then generally we mix them with Makshika or Madhu. So if we are using the drug, means Siddha Ghruta, and we want to avoid Ghruta, then same combination of the drug can be mixed with Ardrak, Swaras and Makshik and can be given to the patient. Even that will give very good results. With Poshana Jala, obviously.
Thank you, ma'am. The next question is, how to give Churna Basti? Please explain in details. Question asked
okay.
by Dr. Payal Khandelwal.
Okay. In Churna Basti, ideally now I will have to open all my secrets, but that is good because it's for sharing of knowledge and benefit of the patient. One of my students has done this particular project in our institute. In Churna Basti, what is done is, Churna, suppose we want to give Churna Basti of Vaishwanar Churna. My student and mine was also published for Churna Basti. Vaishwanar Churna taken in little loaded and mixed with only lukewarm water and Prakshep Dravya, that is generally what we use, Makshika, Pimpri, Saindha, right? So Makshik, Pimpri, Saindha and very little quantity of Sneha. Generally, whenever we, my student has done this clinical trial, she has avoided all Sneha. So only this particular Vaishwanar Churna and lukewarm water was mixed together and was given as a basti to the patient. But it is not to be extended more than 5 days because some patients may have burning sensation. In trial, when my student has conducted this trial, all 20 patients never had any side effect, but a very good Ama Pachan action was achieved with this. So it is like 200 ml of water and 20 gram of churna mixed together and given as a basti.
Thank you, madam. The next question was asked by Dr. Madhura. What can be given in lumbar spondylitis if it aggravates after walking?
As pain is getting aggravated after walking or after chalatva or movements, it means the pain is purely of vata origin. So poshana chikitsa and vata shaman is what is required. And in such patients, ashwagandha rishta will definitely help. Along with that, if one can do a combination. I sincerely feel Kai Chikitsa person saying that I am treating lumbar spondylosis is not good, because in afternoon only my sir called me up and asked me that Ayurveda says that Purusham Purusham Viksha you have to treat. Okay, Ayurveda does not focuses only on the management of the condition, but it should be as per the person. So this will be my general statement, but definitely after clinical examination of the patient, if we feel that this particular patient is having only vata aggravation, then ashwagandha rishta along with that, all the drugs means yashti madhu, shatavari, ashwagandha, kapikachu, bruhana drugs, siddha kruta will help in such patients. In lumbar spondylosis, we have seen that Trayodashang Gugul and Chandra Prabha, if patient is female patient and menopausal patient, then Chandra Prabha will be very useful in such sort of patient, and Yograj or Mahayograj Gugul, because those are Poshana Gugul. So those will give good results, and local application with Narayan Tel as well as Yapana Basti, if patient is lean and thin, but if patient is Kapha Prakriti and obese patient, then Yoga Basti, where Anuasan can be given with Narayan Tel and Niruha with Sashmud Kwap can be done.
Thank you, madam. The next question was, what is the Granthadhar of Ama Gaja Siha Modak Vati?
Amavad Gaja Siha Modak, which I told about the Amavad Chikitsa. It is mentioned in Vaishajya Ratnavali also, and I guess Rasa Ratna Samuch also. But Vaishajya Ratnavali has definitely mentioned it.
Okay, madam. Madam, the next question was treatment for migraine by Dr. Rekha Rathi.
Okay. Treatment for migraine, which comes under the category of Shirashula. If patient is having intense pain, and along with that, if we, while taking the clinical history, if we get that patient is having constipation or no vata anuloman, then what is required is, though there is Shirashul, but vata anuloman should be done, and that is important. So in such patients, vata anulomana chikitsa with snigdha dravya or madhura dravya is essential, because all the Shirashul basically is because of vata pittaja ailment. So in such a patients, vata anuloman can be achieved with eranda sneha. That virechan, mrudu anuloman or virechan can be given with either eranda sneha or aragvad pant, that is madhur virechan. And along with that, for Shirashula, patient should be given godanti bhasma, which is a very good drug for headache. Apart from that, pathyadi kwath can be given. In migraine patient, generally it is associated with this thing, hyperacidity also. So, Suvarna Sutshekhar or Leela Vilas Ras also will give good result in these patients.
Thank you, madam. The next question was related to chikungunya. How do you manage joint pain and chikungunya?
Chikungunya patients I have treated in our OPD and IPD, and I sincerely feel that chikungunya is a what we can say, disease which is neither of dhatukshaya origin nor of srotorodha origin, but mausa dushti is tremendous, and that's why patients suffer from particular pain for longer duration though disease is over. All of us know that upadra of vyadhi is something which gets cured once we treat vyadhi, and udarka the vyadhi is morbid change which remains for a longer duration or sometimes lifelong also. So in chikungunya, we treat it as mamsagata vat or snayugata vat, and in that also we give yogabasti to patient. And yogabasti, after giving yogabasti and kalabasti, means it should be continued for longer duration. And along with that, generally I use Nirgundi Ghana, which is my favorite drug, Rasna Saptakwath, along with Mahavat Vidhams and Trayodasham Rudur.
Thank you, ma'am. Thanks a lot. I know the session will never end, but due to time limitation, I need to cut short this segment, and we'll proceed further now. Thank you. Thank you, ma'am. The next segment is, may I request our respected chairperson, Dr. Chandra Kumar Deshmukh sir, to give precious remark on this presentation. I take this honor to welcome Dr. Deshmukh sir on this platform.
थैंक यू मैडम. आवाज आ रही है मेरी?
यस सर.
सबसे पहले कि अनया पात्रिकर मैडम ने जो शुलग्न चिकित्सा पे पूरा संहिता में जो जो डिस्क्रिप्शन है उसके बारे में डिटेल इतनी इंफॉर्मेशन दी है, उसके बारे में थोड़ा सा मैं, जो गोप्टे आरबी गोप्टे सर हमारे गुरु थे, वो हमेशा बोलते थे कि यथा सौख्यम यथा लाभम, जो जो हमें ट्रीटमेंट इजीली प्राप्त हो वो हमें प्रैक्टिस में यूज करना चाहिए. अभी जो जनरल प्रैक्टिस या हम आयुर्वेद के बच्चे डिग्री होने के बाद प्रैक्टिस करते हैं, तो सबसे पहले उनको प्रॉब्लम आता है पेन मैनेजमेंट के लिए. तो ऐसे बच्चे हमारे पास बहुत सीखने को आते हैं कि विद्धकर्म और अग्निकर्म पेन मैनेजमेंट में कैसा करना चाहिए. लेकिन जो पात्रिकर मैडम ने डिटेल दिया है कि अग्निकर्म, विद्ध कर्म, रक्तमोक्षण, लेप चिकित्सा, चरकोक्त और ग्रंथोक्त जो द्रव्य आए हैं, तो ये सब हमें प्रैक्टिस में यूज करने के लिए बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट है. सुश्रुत में बोला है कि रक्तमोक्षण इज अर्ध चिकित्सा, जस्ट लाइक बस्ती इन चरक संहिता. चरक संहिता में जैसे पंचकर्म में बस्ती बोला है, वैसे हमें रक्तमोक्षण भी एक अर्ध चिकित्सा समान है. लेकिन अर्ध चिकित्सा है, लेकिन जो बाकी की भी चिकित्सा हमें जो इम्पोर्टेंट चाहिए प्रैक्टिस में, वो मैडम ने बहुत अच्छी तरह से बताई है। मैं मैडम को ये बताना चाहूंगा कि अभी मैं हम ओपीडी में थे और हम ओपीडी बंद करके हमारे सभी स्टूडेंट यहाँ पे जो 30-40 स्टूडेंट है सभी ने आपका पूरा लेक्चर पढ़ा है और नोट डाउन भी बहुत अच्छी तरह से किया है मैडम। तो इतना डिटेल में हमें रेफरेंस के साथ कभी नहीं मिलता है, एकाधे प्रैक्टिस करने में हम इतना सही तक पढ़ नहीं सकते हैं क्योंकि पेशेंट रहते बहुत सारे, लेकिन आपके लेक्चर में हमें पूरी संहिता मिल गई आज और इसके लिए बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद मैडम। थैंक यू मैडम।
थैंक यू देशमुख सर फॉर योर मैग्निफिसेंट रिमार्क्स। दिस विल डेफिनेटली हेल्प अस एंड गाइड अस, मोटिवेट अस फॉर नेक्स्ट परफॉर्मेंस। थैंक यू सर।
थैंक यू।
With this, we move on to vote of thanks. I thank everyone who has been a part of this Nyan Yajna series and a part of this journey. After all, every drop in the ocean counts. My sincere gratitude to all dignitaries present today. I thank Dr. Vinayak Temburnikar ki sir, President NEMA CC, Dr. Ashutosh Kulkarni sir, Treasurer, NEMA CC, Speaker, Madam Dr. Anaya Patrikar Madam, Chairperson, Dr. Deshmukh sir, Dr. Suhas Jadhav sir, President, Dr. Anil Bajare sir, Secretary, Dr. Bhushan Mani sir, Treasurer, Dr. Sadhana Madam, Dr. Swapna Jagnale Madam, Coordinators for Webinar Series, Dr. Vishnu Bhavne sir, Dr. Padmanabh Keshar sir, and all office bearers and executive committee members of NEMA MSB. And last but not the least, I want to thank all the participants for attending this CME. Without your continuous support, we would never be able to put on events like this. So let's roll up our sleeves and continue this journey with more dedication and make this Nyan Yajna series stronger day by day. Once again, thank you. Thank you all of you all. Take care. Stay safe. So shall we end this?
Thank National you. Anthem.
Okay.
National Anthem.
Thank you.